What's good? It's your boy Trent, and I'm back one more again. This time I'm back with a brand new music review by the girl Taylor Swift. I'm not no big Taylor Swift fan, but she's been on SNL lately, so I guess she just dropped the project, and she got a new single out. So we about to check this song out. If it's a video, shit, we'll check that out too. But we about to check this song out together, see if we like it. I'm not no like them other reactors or YouTubers. We not gonna skip, pause. We gonna check out the whole song, and we gonna see if it can appeal to me. You know what I'm saying? See if y'all like it also. So make sure y'all subscribe to my channel. Like, share, comment, all that. Yiddy, let's check this out.
Your fucking panties on a bunch and making reaction vids. I hate you niggas that make reaction vids.
This Taylor's All Too Well short film. We about to react to it. So long video. So stick in there with me, man. We're going to check this out. Yiddy. Love is short, forgetting it so long. That's real.
Are you for real?
What do you mean?
I don't know, I just feel like maybe I made you up.
Why are you so pissed off?
Not pissed off, he said I was pissed off.
Because you're acting pissed off.
Did you know why she pissed
ridiculous.
Off? Motherfucker.
These are my friends. They were super fucking nice to you, too.
No, I liked your friends. I never said I didn't like your friends. Why I didn't like the way that you acted around them.
You were being weird and quiet the entire time.
That's not
being
because you wouldn't look at me. Oh, you can ask me one thing the entire night.
That's bullshit. That's such bullshit.
You dropped my fucking hand. What am I supposed to do with that?
I didn't even fucking notice. What are you talking about?
I don't know any of these people. They're all strangers. They're all older than me.
But like, what are you talking
about? I feel so out of place. You're the only one that
can about you.
Look at me.
I'm catching up with friends. You're literally saying I dropped your hand. Like, what? I don't even remember the moment that you're talking about.
Damn.
How can you be like attacking me about something that I don't even like fucking know? I was doing it subconsciously. I was catching up with people.
You're making me feel fucking stupid.
Holy shit. I don't think I'm making you feel that way. I think you're making yourself feel that way. Literally a moment that I don't even fucking remember that you're like fucking like holding me hostage over. It's insane.
Ooh.
It's fucking crazy. These are people I haven't seen in like 10 years. And you just sit there the entire fucking time. It was fun. I actually had a fucking blast. Now this is the night. Now we're doing this. Awesome. So fucking awesome.
You just treated me differently.
What do you mean I treated you differently?
Look at me once!
What are you talking about?
Oh, no,
I'm catching up with my friends!
Trust me, they were enthralled by you, of course.
I'm sorry, you're making me really making the entire night about you!
Look at me!
Holy shit, I can't. It's fucking selfish. It's literally like, it's so crazy.
Oh, so you're selfish now.
Yes, you're making me about you're acting selfish. I've seen you're acting selfish, absolutely. Right now, that's exactly what's happening. Don't fucking look at me like that, that's so fucked up.
Man, just apologize.
Hey.
They got a nice house.
I don't like it. Come on. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I dropped your hand. Come on. Sorry.
And I know it's long gone, and there was nothing else I could do. And I forget about you long enough to forget why I needed to.
That's a 15-minute long video, and I ain't gonna lie, I like the video, man. This is my first time checking this song out, hearing the song, and I like it, you know what I'm saying? I think Taylor Swift's talent is writing these songs and making short films. Like, it was actually, like, it's a short film for real, because it's like a movie. It kind of remind me of The Notebook, you know what I'm saying? That type of style. Like, I know a lot of people haven't watched The Notebook. Y'all need to check that out at least one time in your life, even if you gotta watch it with your girl or some with somebody. But anywho, it started off, you know what I'm saying, like your typical love story, you know what I mean? She young, fell in love with a dude, came through, and the dude had his old friends come around, and you know how sometimes couples act different when they around their friends or whatnot, didn't show no interest to her, you know what I mean? And she was young, she just didn't know how to, you know what I'm saying, handle it. And SNL made a joke about that, like, hey, if you ever been in love with Taylor Swift, and she's made a 10-minute song about you, you must did something wrong. They say it's about Jake Gyllenhaal, you know what I'm saying? And if it is, that means she's still in love. She's still, I don't know if she's still in love with the dude, because she had different boyfriends. I know that about her. But I see, like, I like it when artists put their pain into their music, you know what I'm saying? And like I said, this is my first time listening to it, and I felt the pain. I damn near wanted to cry. Like, it's a sad story. But the good thing about it, you know, she got millions and everything. She probably not phased about it, but she's probably still thinking about it, you know what I mean? So she just thinking about they love life, how it's ups and downs and stuff. Then 13 years later, which is like now, she's moving on. She, the girl was 21 at the time, you know what I'm saying? And she spent her 21 birthday, looked like, by herself. So 13 years later, she put out a book, which is basically a representation of the album she putting out. And she's having like a book signing or a book reading. And all her fans, she blew up, and her fans just there, you know, reading along with her. She talking about the story, you know what I'm saying? And you see at the end, the dude looking through the window like, damn, I messed up a good thing, you know what I mean? Which got me thinking, like, I don't know Jake Gyllenhaal married or got a girlfriend, but I wonder, they could have been the white power couple, you know what I'm saying? Like, if they would have been lasting from back then to now. So that's what the video was dope. I miss videos like that. Remind me of the Michael Jackson age when he was, every single he put out, it was an actual movie or a short film to the song. We need to get back to them days. I know it's the 2020s, and we all about putting out quick music, quick little video. The video don't even gotta have nothing to do with the song. We just singing and rapping or whatever the music is and hurry up and putting it out. But to make a short film is good. Let's give a shout out. I forget their name. Let me get their name, because she put their name in here for the credits. They put their name up here. I got to shout out them actors. You know what I'm saying? So, like I said, it was directed by her. Forget it. It's taking too long to pop up, but the actors did their thing. It made me feel like, damn, they was really, that could have been a long movie. You know what I'm saying? If I believe Taylor Swift got the talent enough to write a love story, it could be about her. It could be about anything. She just got the talent to write and direct in a movie. You know what I'm saying? That could touch you. You know what I'm saying? It touched me, and it's my first time. Which, now that I'm looking at it, it's called Red Taylor's Version, which means this. I remember she put out that Red album. I didn't listen to it because, like I said, I'm not no Taylor Swift fan, but I remember Justin Bieber manager, the dude, I forget his name, Scott or whatever his name is, he bought Taylor Swift publishing or whatever, her masters, and Taylor Swift got the money to buy them, but he won't sell them back to her. So basically what the new artist is doing is they going back in the studio, re-recording their old music and putting it back out. So when you go buy the album, you could go buy the old album or you could buy the new album. That's why she called it Taylor's Version. You could go buy Red and let him get paid off of it, or you can buy the new version and let her get paid over it. My only thing is, they saying that the production-wise is not going to be the same as the original. So my question to the Taylor Swift fans who have heard this album before or heard this song before, do it sound any different? Do it sound like the original, or do it sound like a different version? Let me know. And also, do y'all like this version or do y'all like the original? You know what I mean? And also, I want to react to the whole album, but let's be real, the original album's so old, I don't want to really react to the old albums unless y'all, my subscribers, or anybody who watching this want me to react to the rest of the album. She put it out like 4 days ago. Haven't been out for a week, I believe. With Summer Walker just dropping, putting her pain into her music, it became one of the biggest albums this year. And Taylor Swift got the power to be on that same level or even bigger, re-releasing it. And I'm looking forward to hearing more, but if it's this sad, I don't want to be this sad. Like, it's really a sad vibe. Hopefully she got some happy music on the album. I don't know. But I'm not going to keep y'all waiting too long because, you know what I'm saying, the video is already 15 minutes long. So let me know in the comments, please. Do y'all like this version or y'all don't like this version? Do y'all want me to react to some more Taylor Swift music or some other music? Let me know in the comments. And I see y'all the next time. Make sure y'all check out my other videos because I got reactions for days. You dig? I holler.